class 12. Today I am going to film the video for the second part of the chapter evolution. Here I am focusing on the topic adaptive radiation with few examples. So do watch it and try to understand the topic. My dear students of class 12, this is the part 2 of the chapter evolution. In the previous part I have discussed about the various type of evidences that suggest the evolution or evolutionary biology, morphological evidence, anatomical evidence, biogeographical evidence and biochemical evidence. Here in this video we are talking about adaptive radiation. Before making you understand what is adaptive radiation, let me discuss something about Charles Darwin and his accidental discovery of the island Galapagos, where he made his scientific studies. Now Charles Darwin, he nearly for 5 years he circumnavigated of the globe aboard HMS Beagle. This was his ship by which he has gone to various part of the world. He spent only 5 weeks on the Galapagos Island. Now the year when he went to the Galapagos was 1835, and at that time he was only 26 years old. His discoveries on this island were paramount to the development of this theory of evolution by natural selection. That is very important in this chapter. So he developed the theory of evolution by natural selection after he discovered the various type of finches present in this island. Now this island is present off coast of the South American continent. The Galapagos Islands make up an archipelago of 13 major islands and more than some 100 small islands that straddle the equator of the Ecuadorian coast. Now Galapagos is an old Spanish word which means tortoise. So we can understand here the meaning of Galapagos is the island of tortoise. Now let me tell you about what did Charles Darwin see here and how did he get the idea of natural selection. Now when Darwin went to these islands, he saw that there are at least 26 different type of finches present in the various islands. Now these islands contain various type of finches that were different from each other based on their beaks. So he observed that the variety of food that these finches take were different from each other, and that is the reason why the beaks are so different in all these type of species. So some species had evolved from the natural seed eating finches. So the ancestor of these finches were basically the seed eating finches. Thereafter, when these finches, they actually migrated from the South of American mainland to these islands which are present in the off coast of the Ecuador. Now when they migrated here, their population size started multiplying. So there was a crisis of the food for these finches, and thereafter they migrated to the various islands of this Galapagos archipelago. And eventually what happened, due to the lack of the food resources, they gradually evolved for taking up different kind of food, and that is the reason why their beaks were different from each other and evolved to take different type of food. Thus from the main ancestor of seed eating finches, there evolved the various type of finches. Some were insectivorous while others were vegetarian. Now let me tell you what is adaptive radiation with the help of this Darwin's finches. Now let me make you understand about adaptive radiation with the help of an example. Here you can see in the center I have written one ancestor species A. Now this ancestor species A, this is an organism which is an hypothetical organism this is not in real existence. So let us consider an organism species A having the features of fur, rudimentary eye and claws. Now over time this species A underwent some changes, morphological changes or anatomical changes, as well as in any type of biochemical changes in its body, and it underwent changes, and this gave rise to two different other species, species A dash and species A double dash. Now these two species A dash and A double dash, they never interbreed among themselves, that is they never came together for mating, so they evolved as individual species from the ancestral species A. Now let me tell you the features that they developed. Now species A dash has most of the common characters as that of the ancestor, like claws and rudimentary eye are the same, but here you see the fur nature is a bit changed. It has been changed to silky fur. While the species A double dash, the fur is same as the old species. Eyes are developed here, not rudimentary. Claws are also developed, like sharp claws. And a new feature is developed here in the species A double dash, that is ability to swim. So here you can get the idea how the origin of new species came into existence in case of Darwin's finches. So this is about the natural selection. So nature selects the organism who is better fitted to cope up with the natural changes taking place in the environment, and it survives. So the next topic is adaptive radiation with the example of marsupials. Now let me tell you what are marsupial animals. Marsupials are actually a type of mammals which are non-placental. They do not form placenta, and the young ones are underdeveloped, and they are basically developed in the pouch of the mother. So marsupials are mainly seen in Australia and South America. It is said that nearly 250 species of marsupials are found in Australia alone, and nearly 150 species of marsupials are found in South America. Now you see, the marsupials, basically the ancestor marsupial, which was known to be found during the dinosaur age, was just like a small animal, like a mouse, tree-climbing mouse-like creature that underwent various changes due to natural selection and gave rise to various other marsupial animals. So in your book, there are nearly 10 types of marsupials discussed, which are bandicoot, sugar glider, kangaroo, tiger cat, then banded anteater, marsupial rat, wombat, koala, and various other. So in this way we can see that from the marsupial ancestor, which was just like a mouse which could have climbed the tree during the Jurassic age, has underwent changes due to the course of time, and gave rise to various other animals which are marsupial but has very little changes in their body features. Maybe that is the physiological changes have occurred, maybe there are changes in anatomical structure or morphological structure. So in this way we can see that various stocks of animals are developed from the ancestral stock. So the ancestral stock is the marsupial ancestor. So not only the marsupials, Australia also house a number of placental mammals too. You can see here there are various type of placental mammals like mole, anteater, mouse, lemur, flying squirrel, bobcat and wolf. These are the various type of placental mammals seen in Australia. Now these placental mammals have evolved which appear similar to the corresponding marsupials. Now see how these placental mammals correspond the marsupials of Australia. Now here are the placental mammals which appear similar to the corresponding marsupial animals. You can see here when more than one adaptive radiation appear to have occurred in an isolated geographical area, like here we are talking about Australian continent. So in Australia itself, there are various type of marsupial animal, which I told you nearly 250 types of species, as well as there are placental mammal as well. So when more than one adaptive radiation appear in a isolated geographical area and two or more groups of unrelated animals, they resemble each other. Here you see the mole resemble the marsupial mole, anteater resemble the anteater marsupial anteater, mouse resemble the marsupial mouse, lemur resembles the spotted cuscus, flying squirrel it also resemble one of the marsupial flying phalanger, and bobcat it resemble the Tasmanian tiger cat. Thereafter the wolf, which is a placental mammal, it resembles the Tasmanian wolf. Now these animals, they placental animals, they resemble with some of the features with the marsupial animals, okay, and they live in the same geographical area. Now this is called convergent evolution. So here is the example. But you see, bobcat, though it resembles the Tasmanian tiger cat and Tasmanian wolf resemble the wolf, but Tasmanian tiger cat and Tasmanian wolf are now extinct. So this is about the convergent evolution with the example of adaptive radiation, which was generally put forward by Charles Darwin. So my dear students, hope you liked the video and understood the topic of adaptive radiation. I have tried to explain it with examples. If you have any comment or queries regarding the topic, do comment me in the comment section below. And please don't forget to subscribe my channel. And as I tell you always, do share it with your friends. And thanks for watching. Bye.